Welcome to the Nautic Online Days by Dufour. Today we will be talking about hybrid navigation on the Dufour boats with a special focus on the smart electric technology with Mathieu Fountaine and Romain Modot, who are both deputy CEO of the group. Mathieu and Romain, hello.
Hello.
Hello, Amélie.
Romain, what is a hybrid navigation? What does it mean?
I think it's really clear, and it starts from the vision of really changing the purpose of the navigation inside the monohull in general, and to offer to our clients something which is really new in terms of protection of the environment and also in the silence when you are sailing around on the boat. And I think the engineer team put really together a tremendous now system that really delivered the full vision in having really the way to get all the energy from the different sources, the source of renewable energies that can be stored into a big batteries, and then you can run this electric engine with the electricity. Of course, Mathieu will come back in more detail about that, but I think this is really what we want to achieve. This is really important, that it's to get a large autonomy on the boat and a really silent mode to go into the most protected area and really to look in the long term of the protection on the environment and the ecosystem where we're sailing in.
Okay, so this hybrid navigation technology is called smart electric.
Yes.
How many boats are involved with the smart technology?
So I will probably ask Mathieu to continue on that, but we have today two boats that are sailing on the water, two Dufour and some other catamarans from the Fountaine-Pajot sailing catamaran.
Okay.
On the two boats that we have for the last summer, one was for a private owner in Brittany, and another one was for a Dream Yacht Charter that has been into all different boat shows around the French, Italia, and the Spanish coast to show the installation and everything to the customer. Mm-hmm. And then we have a new phase for the next summer with a much more boat. Mathieu, you want to continue on that because this is we are really in the money time, as we can say, and now this is going to be really implemented in a much more boat.
Yeah, it's really an exciting moment because after the first Aura 51 from Fountaine-Pajot, we start the first monohull with Dufour, and it's for all the team, it's a really exciting project because it's the first electric monohull with the same hybrid system, the same experience, and for the first private owner, it's really interesting that to share the feeling and the experience. They sail during 2 months in Brittany. And yes, for the first Dufour in with the smart electric technology, we have really good results, and we are really happy with that for the beginning.
You were saying that it was the first monohull to have this system integrated. What are the challenges of integrating a hybrid system
this
on
is
board?
The first monohull, and the main challenge is to have the place for the battery, because we have on the boat a bigger battery that to have the autonomy close to 3 or 4 hours at 5 knots. And this is the main challenge, to have the space for the battery. For the engine and for the whole electronic system, it's easiest because we have the same place, that's a thermal engine. And after, also for the safety and for the range extender, we have a genset at the back of the boat. And this is the main architecture for the Dufour 470 and Dufour 530.
Okay, so if you had to explain like exactly how the architecture of the technology is implemented on board,
This is really simple because it's exactly the same like a catamaran, but we have just one side. We have, of course, the engine. This is the same engine, a really powerful engine, that the same space that the thermal engine. This also hydrogeneration system that with this engine. After really close to the engine, you have all the electrical and power management of the system for all the of course for the engine, but for all hotel load and for the AC and 12 volts also. The system manage everything with a really simple and really clear experience for the owner. After you have of course the battery in the middle of the boat close to the keel, and at the back the genset for the safety and for the range extender.
Okay, thank you very much. So we've understood the big picture, but if I go on board, how do I make it work technically? So let's find out with a video of Emmerich Dairy key account sales manager for Dufour.
Donc les bateaux électriques, c'est super simple. Je vais vous montrer comment est-ce que ça marche de zéro quand on arrive le matin et qu'on veut démarrer le bateau. Alors descendez avec moi. Donc en apparence, la seule différence qu'on a sur l'interface dans ce bateau, c'est cet écran, l'écran Smart Elec, qu'on allume avec une simple pression et ça va démarrer le système. Donc là, on voit, ça clignote un peu, le logo Dufour apparaît et là, on a les différents écrans. Avec ce qu'on va utiliser en navigation, c'est la propulsion. Donc ici, on va voir tout le régime moteur, un calcul de l'autonomie. À partir du moment où on va approcher des 30% d'autonomie, le générateur va démarrer automatiquement. Mais on peut aussi forcer le générateur en manuel en appuyant sur ce bouton. Voilà. Et après, on a toute l'interface de gestion de l'énergie, où ici, on voit les différents composants. Donc, on va avoir notre batterie, qui là actuellement est à 49%. On peut bien sûr recharger le système avec le groupe électrogène, qui utilise les réservoirs classiques de diesel. On a également un hydrogénérateur, le pod, l'hélice à partir de 6 nœuds peut être efficace en recharge d'énergie et très efficace à partir de 7 nœuds. Et également là actuellement on est branché sur le quai, donc là il y a le chargeur 12 volts qui va approvisionner le circuit. Cet écran de propulsion on le retrouve bien sûr au poste de barre, donc je vous propose qu'on monte pour regarder à quoi ça ressemble. Donc nous voici au poste de barre, le démarrage est très simple, il y a ici un bouton on-off. Et après il y a deux fonctions, soit la fonction propulsion, soit hydrogénération. Donc sur le bouton de droite, ici on voit la batterie et l'hélice, j'appuie sur le bouton et nous voici en mode propulsion. Alors ça surprend directement au premier usage, le démarrage est hyper silencieux, on n'entend presque rien. Et là directement j'ai l'autonomie qui est calculée. Là, on a 400 tours minute, on aura une vitesse d'environ 3,5 nœuds, une vitesse idéale pour quitter le port, et on n'entend aucun bruit. Donc on a vu ensemble la mise en marche du Smart Elec. Maintenant je vous propose qu'on aille voir les éléments qui composent ce système électrique. Donc bien sûr quand on visite un bateau, on s'attend à voir le moteur, toujours au même emplacement. Et ici, on a le grand vide. On a juste cette boîte à l'arrière qui s'appelle la Wattbox, qui va centraliser tout le système électrique. On voit juste ici le chargeur, puis l'en bas de l'hélice de propulsion, qui est ancré juste ici. Et donc au centre du bateau, au plus proche de la quille, on va retrouver le parc de batteries. Ici on a donc des batteries lithium ferré phosphate, une technologie un petit peu différente de ce qu'on a dans l'automobile, où c'est lithium ion et phosphate. Cette technologie va avoir une recharge plus rapide, mais être moins stable et moins durée dans le temps. Là ici on a fait un choix de sécurité et de longévité.
So that's much clearer now that we've seen the video. Romain, can you tell us how the Dufour Smart Electric models fall within the Dufour's zero net carbon emission strategy?
Yeah, I think that's all the strategy we have for the group, for the entire group that now Dufour is a part for Fountaine-Pajot. And so we are clearly now setting and targeting an ambitious target of carbon neutrality by 2030. And to do so, we made our life cycle analysis in the last year on the carbon emission. And so we find out that 80% of the total emission is coming from the usage phase, including the thermal engine. And to really get a massive amelioration of the carbon emission, we have to replace those engines by the electric engine. And this is really now the aim of the whole project. It's really to be able by 2030 to get this smart electric system as the new heart of the boat and of the whole range of Dufour and Fountaine-Pajot to really deliver this vision of carbon neutrality. Of course, there is thousands of other challenges on the road, but this one is the big one. We can understand that 80% of the whole emission come from the thermal engine, from the construction phase or to the usage phase. So it's clear to understand if we're able either to change that to any other solution that will save the fuel that we have to put on the boat to move the boat, basically, then we will be in a much better position to reach this ambitious target. Into the all different and all others compartment of the companies inside the industry for the HR as well and everything, there's different challenges that are really important as well that we're now addressing those challenges with different other directors, and we are looking really much to have the SBTi certification by next summer.
What does that mean?
Science Based Target Initiative stamp on our climate strategy that will show our strong commitment and also demonstrating that this is science based and this is really credible, let's say, direction and target that we can achieve. This is really important for the whole group, for the all the workers, and also for the, let's say, for the promise we have to the environment and to our customer that this is really something strong.
Great, thank you very much. What are the next steps in the zero net carbon emission strategy?
So I think we are now on track. The two main target that we had in the last 2 years was really to prototype the smart electric system, then to implement it in phase one in 2, 5, 6 model. This is what we achieved for last summer to put it in live with customers on charter and on private ownership. So we have been through that. Then now we really have to scale up that strategy and to really be able by 2027, the target is really to get 50% of the output of our production with this system, and by 2030, 100%. So this is really what we have to do. By summer 24, what I said before is to really have established and having a large and full vision of the decarbonization plan, including for the internal scope, the 1, 2, and 3 for suppliers, for the really technical on that. So, and to make sure that we have really understood the whole financing question to reach the 80% drop in emission, and also the 20% of offsetting that we're gonna have to scale by 2028, 2029, by the end of the plan, to reach this carbon neutrality. So that's a lot of a big stopover into this journey, but we do really believe that we all align on that, and we have a really clear commitment from the whole stakeholders, including the shareholders and the board, because this is for all of them and for all of us really important matter to answer if we want to have a clear ambition for the boating together, all together.
That sounds very promising. Mathieu, is there anything that you would like to add?
No, I think it's really interesting that to have a really strong partner in this really ambitious and really interesting project. That's really good thanks to Dream Your Charter. That it's really, yes, really interesting partnership. And it's really important, especially in this kind of project. And another thing that I think with the smart electric system, and especially with the monohull, that you have a really new experience of sailing, that it's really easiest to use the sail more and to sail with the boat, because you have the electrical engine, you have no noise, that you can combine electrical engine and sailing. And I think, yes, it's really, really interesting for the future.
Do you have anything else?
No, clear and completely agree that it's also a collective, and this is together and all together that we'll be able to reach that target. We, of course, need a dealer, charter company, really valued customer to jump with us on board this journey, but also all the stakeholders, the suppliers, of course, the design office, all the people are really moving around that and really pushing us on one side, but also helping us to deliver that. We'll not do it alone by any way, and we really need to have this collective energy to move on that step and to move and to reach that target.
It has to be a common effort.
Yeah, yes. Definitely.
And you're on the right path to do that. Thank you very much, Romain and Mathieu.
Thank you,
Amanda. And we look forward to seeing the future of green energy in the yachting industry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.